Hi! Let's take a look on how we can integrate tangent x. As we can see, we don't have too much things to work with. Let's break down tangent x as sine x over cosine x, and that will do the job. So this is the same as integrating sine x on the top over cosine x on the bottom. This way, we can use u-substitutions. I will let u equals to, we have two choices, either sine x over cosine x, right? The correct choice is cosine x. And let me show you this is true. Let's differentiate both sides. Du will be negative sine x dx. The derivative cosine x is negative sine x. And I want to isolate the dx, so I can divide both sides by negative sine x. In other words, dx will be du over negative sine x. And we are ready to take this integral into the u world. We'll see. This is the same as the integral. Sine x stays on the top for now, over on the bottom, which is cosine x, but we said this is u, so we have sine x over u. And the dx, it's what we found out to be du over negative sine. So I will replace dx with that, du over negative sine x. And you see, this sine x and that sine x cancel each other out. So we brought this integral into the u world completely. We have a negative right here. Let's take the negative on the outside. So negative integral, here we just have 1 over u, du. And now the matter is, what's the integral of 1 over u in the u world? The answer for that is ln, absolute value of u. So we get negative ln, absolute value of u. And now, what's u? U is cosine x. So we can just write this down as negative ln, absolute value of cosine x. And this is pretty much it. Nothing wrong with this. However, we don't like to have a negative. Let's see how can we take care of that. This is like saying we have negative 1. And when you have a number in front of the ln, we can take the number up, and it becomes the exponent. Okay, so this is technically goes right here. So this becomes ln, absolute value, cosine x raised to the negative 1 power. This is not the inverse cosine. This means cosine x to the negative 1 power, which is the same as saying 1 over cosine x. And what's 1 over cosine x? It's secant x. So finally, we can say this is ln, absolute value, and inside we just have a secant x. And we close the absolute value, and we are done. So we put a plus c. And this right here is a standard result for the integral of tangent x. This is it.